I will continue to do it and nothing will happen. Jason Wike speaks on destroying Igbo businessman's investment. Hey guys, the Minister of the Federal Capital Territory, Jason Wike, has addressed the feud between himself and the Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of the Senecor Group Limited, Nicholas Ukachukwu. Okay. Niger News understands that Ukachukwu had accused the minister of ordering the demolition of his investment on 214 acres of land in the Asokoro district of FCT. The businessman claimed that Wike carried out the act despite pending court orders from separate courts stopping him and the FCT administration from tampering with the property. Ukachukwu claimed that the property was demolished because it was owned by an Igbo man and not because the company violated any law. However, reacting to the allegation during a press briefing on Tuesday, Jason Wike said, the land allocated to Ukachukwu did not have the approval of any minister as his predecessor. The FCT minister said, the land grabbing in Abuja is becoming rampant because some officials in the land department of his ministry have compromised. Wike said, I have been doing this before. I will continue to do it and nothing will happen. Criminals are criminals. They may come in different ways. I have never seen people like land-grabbing people in this place. I came in, I met so many petitions. One company came with different petitions, with different owners of properties. I summoned all of them. They came with their lawyers and senior advocates. Look, what is this? Companies presented their cases. Company A presented their case. Company B presented their own, Company C, Company D, and Company E. I said, okay, I am going to seek advice from external solicitors. I am not going to take advice from insiders because the biggest fraud is that the land department has been compromised. I sought the views of senior lawyers and told them we need to do something differently. This land by the so-called ethnic Jigros was allocated where when there was no minister. The minister left on May 29, 2023. By June, the land was allocated by the director of the land. We all met and agreed that nobody should do anything on the land until we are able to make a final decision. You know what happened? These guys thought they were too smart and they started selling the land. And this is what and where it has led everybody. Nigerians, it's really happening, you know, in Abuja. Abuja is hot. As Jason Wike demolished land, what about 214 acres of land and buildings on it. According to the owner of the land, the Ukachukwu, he said, Ukachukwu Nicholas, he said billions of naira had been destroyed. And he said, Jason Wike did that just because the owner of the land is an Igbo man. If not, he wouldn't have done that. And these have generated reactions from Nigerians, as majority of Nigerians calling Jason Wike names. Waiting be that. No matter what, that is somebody's hard-earned money. Because you feel that you are doing whatever thing you are doing, at least you go step, calm down. You understand? You are doing your job. There is no no need to criticize you about that. But while you are doing that, you have to be very careful. Destroying someone's hard-earned money, someone's property, is not easy. This money that is very hard to come back in Nigeria, because you feel that you want to do what is right and all that. He just went there, he took Budeza and brought down someone's property. It is unfair. Even when you feel that the person is wrong, there are so many ways to go about these things. If they do these things to you, will you like it? Will you like it? You know, if you talk now, they say, wait to make you they talk. This thing when we can do. My people, how na see him? Let's remove the fact that the man is an Igbo man, just like what he said, that the property was destroyed because the owner of the property, you know, is an Igbo man. That is why Nweke did what he did. Make even Bisi no be Igbo person get harm. We are one Nigerian. You understand? If we are really standing by what we are saying, if we are not deceiving ourselves of this one Nigeria, of being together, are we actually together with all these things going on? It's so sad. It's so sad. I feel there are so many ways the FCT minister, you know, would have looked into this issue instead of destroying this property. Then they talk, say, to spoil, in not the ad, but that to repair, it is difficult. He have just spoken as if nothing has happened. He just destroyed someone's property, and you are talking like nothing has happened. As if he just destroyed a property that just worth of 200 million. Even if it's 100 million. Even if it's 100 million. Even if it's 1 million, I meant to say, it's someone's hard-earned money. You understand? It's really very painful. The way he's even talking. Waiting now. Make we take these things easy. Power is transitional. Don't forget that somebody was there before you came on. And those people who was there, they are no longer there. A day will come, you are still going to be the former. That is how life is. The S, the former FCT minister. Today is the former governor of Rivers State. He's no longer there. A day will still come, is going to be addressed as the former. We have to be very careful what we do. Demolishing people's properties is not easy without compensating them. Well, we just pray. Since the owner of the property has called President Bola Tinubu attention to look into this. So that the government will intervene in this very matter. So guys, let's hear from you. What's your take? Kindly drop your comment below the comment section. Share this video. Let it go viral. I beg, like us.